I am here to speak on behalf of Billy Hartwick, but my concern is that you are limiting the time for speaking to only 20 minutes when you have all of these folks here. So parents and teachers, what are the three school rules that our school board has been totally behind in having us trained? We be
safe, respectful, responsible.
What rule might you guys be breaking if you only allow it to 20 minutes?
Respectful is the answer.
Obviously in support of Billy, and the second one is that there was a formal complaint from the JCs against him over the basketball tournament. And that is absolutely, as chairman of the JCs tournament, not true. We did not make a formal complaint. We did not make a complaint at all. There was one discussion with one other principal. And whether I don't know what was carried on beyond that. And it was only a discussion between two people. There was no formal complaint at all. So if that is any of the reasons that this has come about, which you did not state, that that was part of the reason, it has been brought out that that is part of it. I want to make sure it's very clear that there's no way that we did that. If we made complaints against ambitious, overzealous parents, we would be spending a whole year making the complaints, kicking people out of our tournament. That's ridiculous, and I hope you do the right thing on this Sunday.
At the time, I did not know exactly how much of a blessing he would become to my family. Literally, every interaction with him as principal has been welcoming, genuinely caring and concerned, truthful, respectful, encouraging, and reassuring. Every promise made has been promptly fulfilled. His word actually means something. And he has not just the students, but the entire family's best interest at heart. In a world so tragically full of violence, hate, lies, and manipulation, what Mr. Hartwick has to offer our school and the district is rare and should be held to the highest regard. It is my understanding that in his 20 plus years of employment, he has maintained an impeccable record. I'm not surprised in the least. I am, however, surprised by the decision to give him a pink slip. And I stand before you all today as a parent, a voice in the community, and a voter to ask you to rescind his pink slip and return him to his position at Pine Grove School. Imagine every student inspired, challenged, engaged, and cared for by exceptional educators. Imagine your family welcomed, respected, and valued by exceptional schools. Imagine your community united, strengthened, and prepared for the 21st century. That is our district vision. And I think I can speak for everyone here in attendance to show their support when I say that Mr. Hartwick has successfully brought that vision to life at Pine Grove School. Parent and community engagement numbers are always a struggle to keep high, but look around you. I believe the parent involvement and concerns voiced at a higher quantity than I've ever seen speaks volumes in itself. And as a mother of four, I beg you to listen. Thank you. Sorry to say that I don't have much respect left for the school board, because this is the second time this year that you have disappointed me, and I voted for supple with you.
Yes.
I am the aunt of six students that go to Pine Grove Elementary School, several of which are special needs. Mr. Hartwick has made such an impact on those children that I have bragged about the Delmar County School District. My 17-year-old son has special needs and he's at Delmar High School. I have as much respect for Mr. Hartwick as I do for Mr. Fugate. Mr. Hartwick is an upstanding man. You put him into a failing school, a school that was gonna be closed down possibly, and look what he did with it. You should be ashamed of yourself. My parents have been in this community a lot longer than we have. And you guys really should think about
about what you're doing, because you're not acting in the best interest of the school district, nor the children, nor the parents, and definitely not the community. And as you move forward, think about three of you, like somebody else had previously said, are up for re-election. Two of you can be removed. And I will fight for every last one.
To address the reason for placing Mr. Hartwick under paid administrative leave on March 9th. I therefore am the only non-district person who knows the content of that meeting and what was said. In that regard, to Mr. Hartwick's parents, who couldn't be here tonight because of high blood pressure issues brought on by this issue, to the teachers who have rallied, to the parents who have gathered, to the kids that are here tonight, and finally to the members of the school board, I submit Mr. Hartwick did nothing wrong that rises to the level of punishment the district is trying to impose. The district concerns about Mr. Hartwick presented after their quote unquote investigation barely rose to a level that would require a quiet talk or coaching about responding to a stressful situation. There is nothing in Mr. Hartwick's employee file that we have in our possession that indicates any material performance issues or require any corrective action. In a word, there's nothing there. What does rise to a level of unethical behavior are the following two events. First, which occurred after Mr. Hartwick had received his pink slip. On Tuesday, April 3rd, 2018, I received a call from Anna Potter, formerly Anna Hartwick, who indicated she received a very weird call. The caller identified himself via text and then phone as Roger Daly, pastor of the Fort Dick Bible Church. Mr. Daly asked if Ms. Potter remembered that Mr. Daly had coached her son's soccer team and if she remembered wearing dark sunglasses to the field. He then asked if she remembered having a bruised or black eye behind those sunglasses, and she acknowledged that she did. He said he did not want any rumors to get started, but he thought that Billy and Anna had a stressful divorce and wanted to know if an incident with Billy had caused the bruises. She answered no. She had done it to herself by trying to use a bungee cord that snapped back at her, almost lost her eye. He said it bothered him the last 8 years. Eight. and he'd seen other women with black eyes, and it wasn't from tipping over a box or hit by a bungee. She told him she had not been hurt or hit by Billy. Fact, Mr. Daly, representing the school board, went on an investigation of Mr. Hartwick. Mr. Daly, who did not bring up Anna's safety 8 years ago, voted on an issue to issue a pink slip to Mr. Hartwick. Mrs. Potter is the sister-in-law of the school board meeting you're sitting right next to, Frank Magarino, and has never attended the Fort Dick Bible Church. The name careless activity by the school board member to find dirt to attack an employee should not be tolerated. Mr. Daly should be rebuked. He should not be allowed to vote on any other issue regarding Mr. Hartwick, and he owes my brother an apology. In that meeting I attended on March 14th, which is one day prior to the issue of your pink slip, I witnessed a suspicious act by your senior administrative team. Opening the meeting, I stated that Mr. Hartwick suffers from Tourette's syndrome that is recognized by a disability by the ADA. I notified him that the increased stress since the unexplained issuance of the administrative leave, in my opinion, caused the Tourette's symptoms to increase. It was a message of courtesy. They responded that if Mr. Hartwick needs a 504, he should ask. Moments later, they attempted to joke that if Mr. Hartwick gets a companion dog for his disability, they want one too. Finally, the superintendent stated if the other exec gets a companion dog, then he wants a companion pony. And wouldn't it be quite a sight to see him come through the district halls with a pony? That was uncalled for. It is starkly unprofessional, in insulting and by conduct, and everyone should be punished for their poor communication. Everyone, if anyone, should be punished for poor communication in a district riddled with ACLU complaints. It should be the person making the companion pony reference.
Board and Mr. Harris of why letting Mr. Hartwick go would be a mistake.
As a former student, I can easily say that Mr. Hartwick was the most exemplary principal I had during my time in Del Mar County Unified School District. I have the pleasure of having Mr. Hartwick as my principal at Mary Peacock Elementary School and Preston Elk Middle School. While I have nothing but fond memories of Mr. Hartwick in elementary school, what truly stands out in my mind is my relationship with him during middle school. Preston Elk presented a whole new set of challenges for me, as it does for most. For me, middle school marked the beginning of bullying at school for my sexual orientation. I began to dread attending school because each day was marked with a new set of demeaning insults, threats, and harassment. Though I had a phenomenal group of friends, I still felt very much alone. I never really discussed the issue with anyone out of sheer embarrassment and a little bit of self-pride and the fact that I didn't want anyone to inquire further into my sexual orientation. One day, a rather innocent kid made a comment that was the proverbial straw that broke the camel's back. I lashed out with my own set of insults back, which landed me in the principal's office face-to-face with Mr. Hartwick. I knew I was in trouble. Mr. Hartwick asked me for my version of the events, and after my rather apathetic response, Mr. Hartwick responded, "This is out of character for you. Is something else going on?" After a couple of moments of thought, the tears started streaming down my face. I began to inform him of the bullying that I had experienced over the past months. While I was still disciplined for my inappropriate conduct, Mr. Hartwick got me the help that I needed. He further called the bullies into his office and got to the bottom of the situation, and the bullying stopped. While I am rather embarrassed with this story, I offer it for a few reasons. First, the fact that Mr. Hartwick noticed that my behavior was out of character exemplifies what a remarkable administrator he truly is. Mr. Hartwick not only knows his students by name, he also understands them, their demeanor, and character, and attempts to establish an individualized relationship with each one of them. This is an attribute that was unique to having Mr. Hartwick as a principal. Second, this story shows the true lengths that Mr. Hartwick will go to see his students succeed. At the time of the bullying, my grades were slipping, interest in school was waning, and honestly, the last thing I could do was think about my academics. Mr. Hartwick changed all of that by promptly seeking the appropriate help to ensure me, for me, to ensure that this bullying would not be an impediment to my future. He made me feel as if I had someone in my corner while holding me accountable for my actions. I credit Mr. Hartwick with so much of my academic success by stopping this problem before it manifested into something further. I now attend the University of San Francisco School of Law and will be graduating with my Juris Doctor in spring 2019, and no doubt is Mr. Hartwick partially responsible for this accomplishment. Finally, I offer the story as an analogy to the conduct of this school board and its superintendent. In my opinion, their conduct is nothing short of bullying. We all face challenges in our lives, and there will always be bullies out there to prey on our differences. However, we need more people, especially in our schools, that will stand up for kids, respect their differences, and treat people justly. In the times in which we live, we need more people in Del Mar schools like Mr. Hartwick. He was a champion for me and so many others during one of the most difficult times of my life. I fear that Mr. Hartwick has unfortunately become the target of conduct that is nothing short of what I experienced over a decade ago in middle school. Allowing this bullying of an adult to persist would be grossly unjust result for someone who has fought against this conduct in children. Maybe if Mr. Harris and the school board had a role model like Mr. Hartwick when they attended school, they would know that their conduct is wrong and they must be held accountable for their actions. Sincerely, Dalton D. Bradbury. The pleasure of bumping into many past students that I shared with Mr. Hartwick at the time that I was his assistant principal at Preston Elk. And their stories are all similar of how his personal touch in their lives at a very difficult time turned them around and made an improvement in their life. And I agree, letting him go as an administrator, sure, we have an impact in our classroom, but our impact in our classroom is to our 20 or 35 students that we're responsible for. An impact that a principal has on a large scale touches every student in our school. And Mr. Hartwick is out there touching every student in our school. He knows them by name. He calls them by name. He holds them accountable, and he cares, truly, genuinely cares about them.
And I challenge anyone to find one thing in that that's wrong, because it's not. That's what we need in our schools. That's what he said.
My name is Michelle Moore, and I'm a mother to 9 children. I've been a foster parent for over 17 years and over 100 children in my home. I'm currently a foster parent mentor for the Delmar County Department of Health and Social Services. I'm also the education facilitator for the College of the Redwoods Foster Kinship Program. I sit on the Foster Youth Education Advisory Board with the Delmar County School District, and I'm also a Juvenile Justice Delinquency and Prevention Commissioner. Mr. Hartwick has been an amazing principal through my children's careers, from Mary Peacock to Crescent and currently at Pine Grove. I've not only been able to work with him as a parent that is in the school weekly volunteering to make sure my children are successful at school, but under him as a middle school cheer coach. As a foster parent, adoptive parent, Mr. Hartwick has went over and above to understand my children's trauma and help them succeed the best they can in a school setting. He doesn't hesitate to call and say, "This is out of character. What's going on?" He is very open and easy to communicate with. He always makes time to listen. He gives advice for ideas to make these children successful. My children look forward to Mr. Hartwick outside greeting them every morning. He's not only a principal, he's a friend to these children, a principal who's willing to get down on their level. I've had the opportunity this year to sit on the SAR, Student Attendance Review Board, as a Juvenile Justice Delinquency Prevention Commissioner. With Mr. Hartwick, we have been thinking outside the box to make education a success. Why are you not at school? What can we do to help get you there? It's not about the sanctions we could impose, but breaking down the barriers to get these children to school. Mr. Hartwick is one of the best administrators we have, and it'll be an injustice to our children to lose him. Thank you.
Student body president. Mr. Hartwick has been my principal for 4 years. Since he has been my principal, he has greeted me outside every morning, gives me knuckles, and often we chat about the San Francisco Giants. Unfortunately, we have moved out of the school zone, and my brother Silas started kindergarten this year and was unable to come to my school where everyone knows him. Mr. Hartwick tried his hardest to get him at Pine Grove, and hopefully this year Silas will be able to be student at Pine Grove as a first grader. Mr. Hartwick was always right there asking about my brother and how he's doing because he cares. I think it's sad that involved he is in my family and that when my brother finally gets to come, Mr. Hartwick might not be his principal. That makes my family sad. I recently became student body president and him and I have been working on things for next year. Now we just have to restart. That is not right. Mr. Hartwick is a joyful person, and our school is like one big family. You want to take that away from our school? Please, from the bottom of my heart, my family's heart, and the rest of Pine Grove family, please make the right decision and do not let him go. Sincerely, Aiden Thomas, Student Body President, Silas, and parents.
Because of a disability, and whoever made those comments about a disability, we're screw off. So I pulled my son out of school because the principal, the previous superintendent, Mr. Olson, and the previous school board president right there, John MacArthur, could not resolve what I knew was a serious issue at Bess Maxwell. The headlines. You guys agreed that it would be a no live lives, no knit upon return policy. You guys stated to me that there's no way that you guys could write a policy that everybody could understand and follow correctly. What's up with the PPIS then? Mr. Hartwick, however, made a solution when I went there. He agreed that if there's a headlights problem, that if Matthew could go to school, then he will call me if there's a headlights problem. He has not caught headlights once at that school. I've had multiple encounters with him, actually. There's also a lunch lady, Ms. Chris, who I've had problems with, and he had witnessed one of them. He dealt with the issue before I even had a chance to complain. I've had to call the previous superintendent multiple times at the other school to complain. I've been threatened that I was going to be turned into the truancy because I did not want to send my son to an unsafe school. Mr. Hartwick also helped move the breakfast time to an earlier time. I have to go to work at 7. I can't make breakfast for my son and I feel bad. But he made it at an earlier time so that way my son could have time to eat lunch. He also had multiple problems with another student sexually harassing my son and trying to get him to kiss him and talking about his butt. Instead of following through, instead of just suspending him, he found a solution to help this student, also help my son feel safe at school. So it's not about liking Mr. Hartwick. You can tell everybody likes Mr. Hartwick. It's about issue resolution. It's about problem solving. John MacArthur does not solve problems. He just excuses it. Nobody else. My son now does not go to a school district school. He goes to USA. If Mr. Hartwick is not principal, my younger son, who I plan to go to Pine Grove because I know that there's a principal that's going to solve issues, then he's also not going to go to a school district. He's just going to go to USA as well. You guys need to keep Mr. Hartwick, and you guys need to stop discriminating against him because of his disabilities. Please do not fire the best employee you guys have in this district.
That the board has pushed forward, I cannot say that my children will take part in any form of schooling from the district. It scares me to think that this dismissal is how the board chooses to spend their time and our money on things of this nature. There are plenty of real issues to focus on, like our county middle school drug, gang, and overcrowding problems. Tackle something that needs to be fixed desperately. Pine Grove is already in the most capable hands I can think of. I hope you're all ready for the storm that is fast approaching. The number of parents and community members that are behind our school's principal will be impossible to ignore if you continue down this path. So there's a group of parents also that have been collecting petition signatures, and we have 520 from parents. I printed a copy for each of you with 209 online signatures for people that aren't even being part of this community anymore, but have been in the past and have real knowledge of Mr. Hartwick. And a lot of the wonderful comments specifically about what he's done for our community, for our children, for our schools. And please just do not do this to our kids. Really, ultimately, the kids are who are suffering. Don't do this to them. Thank you. Personally greet each child by name who walks through the school doors to make sure they get inside safely. Do you know that he is a very hands-on principal and has talked to me on many occasions about my child's progress? It is not unlike him to chat with me in the pickup line and say, I just want to tell you I'm so proud of you and your son, and whatever you're doing, keep it up because you're doing a great job. I hear just as much support coming from the parents whose children need the extra attention as well.
Mr. Hartwick is well respected, obviously. It's obvious that he cares about his school and each of the students. The family atmosphere that he has created at the school, plus the personalized attention he gives, is one of the many reasons why I love Pine Grove. He was also my principal in middle school. And I can tell you I've had nothing but positive experiences with him all along. As a parent that has been at every school function, play, family lunch, and field trip, I'd like to ask you how much attention or interaction and firsthand experience do you have at Pine Grove School, if any? If the answer is none, then I believe you have no business disrupting our school and taking away such an important role model that has our children's best interests at heart. I am so disappointed in the school district for clearly showing their own agenda and letting go of such a good principal and person in general. I ask that you please consider what the parents and staff have to say, the ones who know Mr. Hartwick best, and do the right thing. I have some things that have been posted on social media of parents that I don't believe are here, and I would like to read their comments. This is from Heather. He really helped make a difference with my daughter and son's education. Both had been struggling. We put a plan in place with goals to follow that he followed up with and with their teachers. And he also reached out to me. I have never had a teacher, let alone a principal, go above and beyond for my children the way he has. Now my girl is catching up and feeling good about school, and it's not a fight to get her there. You might hear some of your comments in here. Michelle, this is from Michelle. This man went above and beyond for my family the moment he found out about our home burning down. He greets my kids every single morning and makes sure my babies are okay. He's one of the best principals we have in the school district. Marilyn, I am in full support of Billy Hartwick. There aren't enough words to express how I'm feeling right now concerning Billy. I can remember when he first came to the board, he was filled with so much enthusiasm. I remember when he asked me to come on board 5 days a week for the salad bar. Our school is the one that brought the salad bar on for at least 5 days a week versus 2 days a week because of Deborah Kravitz, myself, and the lunchroom staff, and Billy. We were a huge success. It was so much fun watching Billy. I knew he was in his rightful environment. He is someone you can count on. He loves his staff. He loves the children. Family lunch a day has always been one of his favorites. He loves watching the staff and the parents working together. Billy is reliable, fair, and trustworthy. To lose him would be a huge loss to our Pine Grove family, and family it is. We love our principal.
Thank you for the opportunity to address the Board of Trustees and the Superintendent today. My name is Gary Blatnick. I'm a resident of Delmar County, and I currently serve on the School Systems Implementation Team. And some of you may know me, I recently retired as the Director for the Delmar County Department of Health and Human Services. My request to your board is to take the time and halt the current adverse action against Mr. Bill Hartwick and retain him as principal of Pine Grove Elementary. My questions are, how can removing an elementary school principal with 18 years of experience and excellent history of performance be consistent with your stated district goals, mission, and vision? Is there bias or discrimination against Mr. Hartwick? Should there be an opportunity for Mr. Hartwick to speak to the entire board, either publicly or in closed session? Is there a personal vendetta being held toward Mr. Hartwick? While we understand there is a time for privacy and personnel matters, your stated bylaws provide for the opportunity for full disclosure and examination of all relevant facts. In this case, at least hearing directly from Mr. Hartwick once he is made fully aware of the accusations. This process can serve to prevent serious errors and allows for transparency and accountability. Recruiting and retaining high-quality professionals is always a challenge for our community. Losing Mr. Hartwick would be tragic. If he had committed some egregious act, you would have not allowed him to return to the Pine Grove Elementary campus. That is not the case. Therefore, the question is, if Mr. Hartwick did in fact make an error in judgment or action, why would you not utilize progressive discipline? Furthermore, what message are you broadcasting to your principals and other at-will employees? On a personal note, I witnessed an example of what Mr. Hartwick is all about. When, with Mr. Hartwick and others at our local golf course, two young men approached Mr. Hartwick. After their friendly conversation, I inquired how he knew them. He told me their names and that they had been first grade students of his many years ago. I imagine there are hundreds, if not thousands, of former students who feel a personal and positive connection to Mr. Hartwick. Our community has the great fortune to have a gifted educator who loves his work and cares deeply for his students, their parents and guardians, and his colleagues. I respectfully request the board take the time to carefully re-examine all sides of this issue and keep Mr. Hartwick as principal. The students are counting on you. Your decision will have a major impact on the youth of our community now and into the future. Thank you.
My kids actually don't even go to his school. However, I've known Billy Hartwick for a very long time. And my kids go to Crescent City Poor Square Church. This would be the first year they would be going to public school. We are in the Pine Grove District. I was super excited for Mr. Hartwick to be the principal. And I'm actually highly, highly disappointed in you gentlemen. I'm very, very happy Kevin Hartwick came up here and spoke. I have a son with Asperger's who is autistic. He doesn't need a damn dog. Neither does Billy. So next time, shut your mouth. I will keep paying the $10,000 a year for my kids to go to private school to keep him away from judgmental people like you.
As a parent. My children, my family has had the pleasure of having Mr. Hartwick as our children's school principal from the very beginning of our children's school career. To be exact, Mr. Hartwick has had the opportunity to help mold and shape a Johnson child for 15 years as a principal in our district. 15 years, that's a long time. I've known him. Mr. Hartwick came to Mary Pickard School when our oldest child, Silas, was in first grade, and then moved with him to Crescent Elk when he was in the seventh grade. My child felt safe in the transition from Little Mary Peacock to the Big Pond of junior high. It helped knowing that Mr. Hartwick was their principal. They knew that he is someone they felt comfortable talking to. Over the years, Mr. Hartwick got to know our family pretty well. On many occasions, I would receive a phone call from Mr. Hartwick to discuss a concern with one of my children's behaviors, and the conversation would always start the same, with this is out of character for said child. Mr. Hartwick was always willing to help figure out or to get to the root of our behavior. At one point when my son was in the third grade, he was not meshing well in the classroom environment. He kept getting into trouble and was just off. So we had a conversation about how the class was not working for several reasons. We came to an agreement and my child was moved into another third grade class with a teacher who had a classroom with an environment that was better fit for my child's learning style. When my oldest child graduated from Crescent, Mr. Hartwick walked up to me after graduation was over at the school dance and said, "We did it," gave me a high five and a big hug. He goes, "I was worried there for a little while." He told me how proud of the young man my son has turned into. Mr. Hartwick is an amazing child advocate. Being a foster adoptive parent, sometimes our children just don't fit into the same square peg as others. He treats each child as an individual. He knows their names, he knows their individual personalities, and when they're just having an off day, which to me is very important. Our family's youngest child is currently in kindergarten at Pine Grove, so we are lucky to experience the joys of having Mr. Hartwick as a principal again. I love the fact that he greets the children at the front door with a smile and asks them how they are doing each morning, asks how their weekend was, and just gives a general feel for the atmosphere of the school for the day. This is a unique experience
that I have only witnessed at Pine Grove School. In November, I had the opportunity to interview for a position that I had been studying in at Pine Grove School as an IA in the resource class. During my interview, he asked me, why Pine Grove? Why out of all the schools did I choose to interview and work for Pine Grove? My answer came easy. The students. I love my students. I love the staff and our work environment. I feel like we have an amazing workplace and a pretty awesome work family. Sadly, this has changed. On Friday, March 9th, our happy-go-lucky workplace had a great big, huge black cloud hanging over it, as our fearless leader had been put on administrative leave for 5 days. On Monday, March 12th, the entire school staff at Pine Grove was invited to come to a meeting, and Mr. Harris was coming to explain what was going on to us all. We all sat and listened for close to an hour, and when we left, I think we were all more confused than when we walked into the door for that meeting. Just before kindergarten lunch, Mr. Hartwick was allowed to return to work. A little black rain cloud has lifted, and we are all super excited to see him. Life as we know it at our school was returning to normal again, or so we thought. On Thursday, March 15th, the other shoe drops. Mr. Hartwick has been given a pink slip. What? Why? The questions continue. Rumor upon rumor has been told, from hostile work environment to requests for security cameras on our campus, which we asked for. As a Pine Grove staff member who signed the letter sent to you about our work environment, I again affirm that Mr. Hartwick runs a pretty tight ship. We love our boss and how our school is run. I love walking into our school office and not seeing out of control children. I love seeing our principal pop in and out of the classroom all day long. He knows where and who the children are that need a little extra attention. As you can see, I have had the pleasure to work in many capacities with Mr. Hartwick, from parent to employee, and I beg you, rescind this pink slip. The children in our community need a strong, positive role model such as Mr. Hartwick. Pine Grove students need him as our principal. Pine Grove staff needs him as our leader. Yeah. I have a six-year-old foster child who is the kindergartner at Pine Grove, and I just want to tell you a story about today. She was talking about a pink slip, has no idea what that means, and I said, well, that's for the talk. Don't worry about it. So then walking her into Ms. Pitt's class today, she goes, but the cops were talking to Mr. Hartwick. And I'm like, the cops were talking to Mr. Hartwick. She goes, yeah, the cops were talking to Mr. Hartwick. And I said, oh, that's because the bad guy got into our campus where they wasn't supposed to and did stuff they weren't supposed to be. You gotta realize that in her little mind of trauma, cops are bad people. Cops come to take your mommies away and put you in jail because of her babies. So I said, Mr. Hartwick's okay. He went on a conference with mom. It's okay, he'll be back today, you'll see him. So I went and found Mr. Hartwick and I said, could you please pop in and talk to my little one? She's concerned because the cops were talking to you the last time. She's seen you, and she hasn't seen you since vacation. So he took the 5 seconds, walked in, made sure she was safe, made sure she was okay. And so when she got in the car today, she goes, Mom, guess what? I'm like, what? She goes, guess where I see Mr. Hartwick? I said, well, where? She goes, he came into my class, and he came to see me. That's above and beyond.
On March 9th, we as a staff at Pine Grove received an email saying that our principal was no longer on campus for that day and continued to be out for the rest of the next week until further notice. We later received an email saying we would have an all-staff meeting with the superintendent, Jeff Harris, on Monday the 12th. We all as a staff went into the weekend not knowing what was happening with our principal, who is our biggest supporter of the school. On March 12th, all the Pine Grove staff went into this meeting not knowing what was going on. I personally had no idea who Jeff Harris was or even looked like. I'd never seen him in our school. I felt like Jeff Harris never answered the question of why our administrator was gone and when he would return. I felt as if we all came out of that meeting more confused about the whole situation before going into the meeting. I've always felt I to be open with Mr. Hartwick and never had told anything back for him. He is always there to listen or answer questions. Mr. Hartwick is always walking into the classroom asking how our day is going and if we need anything. The kids are always excited to look forward to seeing Mr. Hartwick. I have no doubt Mr. Hartwick would feel as if he is the best person to be in the administrative position of Pine Grove.
I couldn't agree with you more.